The application, or as Vinay calls it, the peroration. All the discourses of the pulpit may be comprised in two kinds, discourse of doctrine and of morality, of fact and of right. They all have common characteristics of exciting the hearer to some action. Sermons should press them to action some way. Moral discourse impels us to it immediately, in its direct end and its end apparent from the first. It proves or assumes the necessity of the action that we are trying to convey. It treats this action itself and nothing else. Remember, the sermon is to be about one thing, and you should be able to boil down your sermon into one point. Doctrinal discourse urges to it likewise, but not immediately or in a manner distinct, though to exempt the orator from pressing the consequences of the truths which he has expounded. If, when you have accomplished your design, you feel no necessity of adding anything, let nothing be added. You're done. You've probably made an application without suspecting that you are even doing so, but it must be there. In a doctrinal discourse, it's the last inference. In a moral discourse, it is the last argument or last direction. It's required again in order to bring together the instructions which you've already given, to compress them within a small space so that they may be regarded collectively. The application, I think, should do something more than merely reproduce the idea of the sermon, which many pastors fall into, a reiteration of what he's already said. No, no, it should present this under a new form, a new aspect, so that this kind of application may be substantially pressed into the heart and the mind of the hearers. It should be a nearer approach made to the hearer in order to impress more forcibly on his heart the truths that he's been hearing. Vinay says this, "For the purpose of the gospel, its distinctive characteristic is to engraft divine sentiments upon the human nature." You're not just talking to give doctrine, you are pressing these into the minds and hearts and souls of those who listen. So in whatever way we terminate the sermon, it's difficult to do it well, and more rare, I think, to begin it well. We are naturally more desirous and careful to making a good beginning than we are to make a good ending. And a lot of pastors throw out the application because they think that's the work of the Holy Spirit, and that's hogwash. Ministers must make a good ending. It is not a separate and independent discourse. The application is the result of your discourse.